I want to thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak about the COP16 to be held in Cancun very soon here in Mexico. And it gives me particular pleasure to be speaking from the Monarch Butterfly Sanctuary here in my home state of Michoacán, Mexico, a living example of why protecting the environment is so important. In Cancun, all nations will have an opportunity to make significant progress by adopting a broad and balanced set of decisions to reduce emissions and begin a new era of effective global action. Our relationship with the environment has come to a turning point. Either we change our way of life to stop climate change, or climate change will alter the way we live. Climate change is affecting already millions of people. We have seen hurricanes and flooding, droughts and forest fires. It is clear that these events are happening in countries across all regions, regardless of their size, geography, level of development, or economic strength. No one is immune. Thankfully, there are now reasons that allow us to be slightly optimistic concerning the outcomes of Cancun. In the more recent negotiations, significant progress has been made that will allow us to deliver immediate actions in different areas, such as adaptation. There is widespread agreement on supporting adaptation actions in developing countries. Technology. There is a consensus on the establishment of a technology committee to coordinate regional centers that will facilitate access for developing countries to green technologies. Fast start financing. There is convergence on the need to include fast start financing as part of the Cancun outcome. Long-term financing. There is agreement to establish the Green Fund in Cancun to provide long-term financing to developing countries. Reductions of emissions from deforestation and soil degradation, the Red Plus mechanism. There is support for a mechanism to implement projects in the forestry sector in developing countries, funded by different sources and respectful of the rights of indigenous communities. However, I believe more is needed to ensure real progress. First, convergence on a below 2 degrees Celsius goal subject to scientific review. Second, many developed countries have made commitments to reduce emissions and many developing countries to take actions. In Cancun, we must ratify these commitments on the basis of the principle of common but differentiated responsibilities and respective capabilities. Third, we can also agree to encourage transparency through a measurement, reporting, and verification scheme, as well as to continue international consultation and analysis. To really move forward, we have to discard the false dilemma that we must choose between economic growth and fighting climate change. It is possible to achieve economic development and, at the same time, reduce emissions and the overconsumption of natural resources. In fact, the only sustainable path to growth is a low-carbon path. Slowing climate change is a large task, and there is only one power on this planet which is equal to it, the power of humanity itself. We will work on the treaties and the diplomacy, and we will work on the science, but let us work above all, harnessing the ability of mankind to change the future. And let us make Cancun the beginning of powerful climate change cooperation that restores faith in our ability to work together and overcome our difficulties as one global village. In Cancun, we can.